say more, 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 more,
I'm starting a new series for all of the people who don't like to cook, but they love to have meals at home like me. So first, we boil our water. Then we add in some penne noodles. These ones are from Trader Joe's. They're brown rice and they're so good. Then we add in some marinara sauce. This one is unmatched. I always do a little bit of greens or some meat, and that is literally it.
Hey, I'm gonna show you guys how to make the perfect baked chicken breast.
Let your chicken rest room temp 20 minutes, then hit it with olive oil or melted butter, both sides, your favorite seasoning. Here's what I use, guys. I just keep it simple. Into the oven, 450, 15 to 17 minutes, 165 internal temp. Let it rest for 5 minutes, at least 5 minutes before you cut into it, guys. I make this every week for meal prep. It's so easy and delicious.
Here's one of my favorite ways to make healthy chicken and rice taste really delicious. Get some chicken breast, add olive oil, salt, pepper, garlic powder, smoked paprika, mixed herbs. Mix till each piece is well coated. Then in a hot pan, add your chicken, cook for 2 minutes, then flip. Lower the heat and add a can of chopped tomatoes. Season again, then cover and let it simmer for 10 minutes. Then you're ready to serve with some hot rice and you got yourself a delicious, healthy meal. Enjoy.
I don't understand women who can't cook. And I ain't talking about cooking for a man, bitch. I'm talking about cooking for yourself. Like, I feel like cooking is a skill that you should know regardless of gender. You need to be able to make you something good to eat. Period.
You must follow food TikTok. Knowing how to make food from a box is not good enough. Knowing how to order food online is not impressive. Come to food TikTok and I will show you how to cook such amazing food that your friends and family.
I'm on a mission to eat less takeout, so when we had a craving for Chick-fil-A, I decided to make it at home. I sliced my chicken breast thin and put it in pickle juice, and I let it marinate for a couple of hours. Then, after dumping out the pickle juice and rinsing off the chicken, I decided to add the eggs directly to the bag. That way I didn't have to waste another bowl. Then I just bread it normally like a regular cutlet. And here's where it gets cool. I decided to make it two ways, traditionally fried and air fried. For the air fryer batch, I added olive oil to the rest of the breadcrumbs. And you want to put enough olive oil to make it into like a wet sand consistency, where it kind of sticks together in your hands like wet sand. That way you don't have to spray your chicken before you put it in the air fryer. Then you just cook as normal. I put it on the chicken setting in the air fryer and I fried the rest. I even had some extra packets of Chick-fil-A sauce. It tasted so good.
All right, check it out, folks. I'm going to show you how to make a quick and easy, super cheesy mac and cheese. All right, very simple. All right, come on, let's go. First things first, bring your water to a rolling bowl, add plenty of salt. From there, add your macaroni, cook it according to instructions, put it to the side. In the heated pan, let's go ahead and bring some heavy cream to a low simmer. Let's season it. We got salt, onion powder, paprika, garlic powder, a little bit of Cajun. Give it a nice whisk. And from there, let's come in with our cheese. Colby Jack, whisk it up. Sharp cheddar, whisk it up. From there, smoked Gouda, whisk it up. From there, go ahead and pour that cheesy goodness over your macaroni and give it a nice mix. Hold up. You hear that? That's how it's supposed to sound. Again, go ahead and mix everything up till it's evenly combined. Add more sauce if need be. Just go ahead and mix until everything is evenly combined. And then from there, we're gonna top it off with more cheese, sharp cheddar, mild cheddar, whatever you like. Make sure you get maximum coverage in the oven for about 25 minutes till we get a nice crust. Bring it out, woo-wee. Hit it with some parsley for some nice color. This will not disappoint, I'm telling you now. Give it a try. More recipes, check me out on YouTube.
Let's make these healthy crispy chicken tenders with the perfect crust using no oil. Cut your chicken into strips, season with salt, pepper, garlic powder, paprika, cayenne pepper. Mix it all up and put it to the side. Add your crushed cornflakes and use the same seasoning you just used. Mix that all up, then crack two eggs in a bowl and whisk. Line a baking tray, then simply dip the chicken in the egg wash. Let it drip, put it in the crumbs, making sure they're all evenly coated. Then bake for 18 minutes at 200 degrees, flipping halfway, and you're ready to eat while they're hot.
What's the one meal that you would eat every single day and never get tired of? Mine is sweet Chinese sausage with a fried egg and some kimchi. I like to boil my Chinese sausage first and then put it in the air fryer for it to be nice and crispy. Add some black pepper and Knorr seasoning sauce to the egg, and then I add my pickled garlic and serrano chilies, which you can find the recipe for on my page. I tried a new recipe and it came out so good, I had to share it with you guys. What I love about it is it takes one dish, it has low maintenance, and it gets done with really inexpensive ingredients. The only ingredients in here are carrots, potatoes, onions, and stew meat. A little bit of olive oil and salt and pepper, and you're good to go. Of course, you can add whatever spices you like or any other vegetables for that matter. Make sure to cut everything to bite-sized pieces so that everything cooks evenly and comes out tender. What's great about this meal is this is something you can double batch and just freeze it for another day when you're busy. I add the potatoes and the carrots to the bottom with a little olive oil, salt, and pepper, and I add the meat mixture. An important tip is to massage the onions with the meat so that the juices can start flowing. I was told this is really important. Then you wrap it really tightly. I have parchment and foil to keep the steam in. Bake at 450 for 15 minutes and 350 for an hour and a half.
What's up, guys? I'm doing more home cooked videos. So I had just like a really thinly sliced filet mignon that I cooked on the cast iron. Ooh, sorry. And then I made some onion gravy with it too. So I made like the homemade little like brown gravy, and then asparagus, of course. Asparagus. Move y'all closer. I also got some asparagus. Some of the like red potatoes. Babe, those potatoes are bomb, aren't they? Tabasco. Steak is good.
Wow, look at this big daddy meal that my beautiful grandma made me for my birthday.
And grandma's having bread.
Oh, and grandma's having bread, and look at her tree. Hey, Graham, get the hell out of here and go turn on your tree. Oh my God, it looks unbelievable. Let me take a quick big daddy bite and then get back to my thoughts and then get back to my family. All right, here we go.
I'll have a big daddy bite of butter, please.
Oh, Graham, look at this. Peas and potatoes. If you don't do it this way, you're not doing it right.
And the gravy, yeah. Mm. Thank you, darling.
Homemade mashed potatoes. We know the difference. We know the difference between store-bought and homemade. Look at that. Gorgeous. Delicious. Wow. I'm so happy.